Well, Carnival, we moved to Paris with the two little girls and the two French poodles and all that. And I always wanted to do a film using Ciné's cartoons. I always wanted to do that. So now I'm here at the right place, and I met one person who was also from America. So there was some contact, you know. And then what happened, I went to Ciné. I had a certain amount of money, and I said to him, I want to buy, give me 8 gags, and I give you so much money. So he gave me 8 gags that I bought, you know. And then what I find out a couple of days later, I could go to London and get those things for nothing, because in Paris, the same gag belonged to somebody from Paris. But in London, the same gag, you know, but somebody else. So they stole from each other. And I could have gone to London and get it for nothing. It was published, you know. But anyway, then I went to Ciné, and I was so surprised. He's a little guy, very gentle, quiet. And yet, you know, when he had an exhibit in Paris, the doors were closed. You had to knock on the door, and then you can go in and see the exhibits, because they were so wild, so ugly, so oversexed, you know, all that stuff, that the police wanted them to have the door closed. But if I knock on the door and they look out and I'm an adult, they would let me in and see the exhibit. But that was also the presence of Ciné, you know, with his gags. And they're funny, they're good stuff. So the whole thing was that he gave me 8 gags, you know. I gave him like $200 or whatever. Then I find out I could open up the magazine and get it for nothing, you know. But there's no big deal. The big deal was I met Ciné, you know, that was good. And then I met somebody else who was animated. So anyway, I put the film together. And so I remember the first time I showed the film at some event, and the French were so happy because they finally felt that they have a funny cartoon that's, you know, really belongs to Paris. And they didn't ever realize that it belongs to me. You know, but the problem was they wanted it to be French, you see, so forget Jules Engel, you know. No big deal, I wasn't pushing it, you know. And the film was done, and I was very lucky to bump into people that were so nice and kind and helped me. Because it was easy to buy a gag, it was easy to find somebody to animate, but still a film had to be put together. You need to go to a place where you can use the machinery, you know. I met somebody else, and they owned a good studio in Paris, and so they let me use the equipment for editing and also for music and stuff like that. But but all the time, you always run into little problems. You know, the man who let me use his studio and use his place where I can edit, you know, he wanted credit as a producer. Now, what the fuck are you talking about? I mean, and he was a nice person, you know, but he wants a credit like that. I mean, no way, you know? So you always had something that you had to jump over, you know what I mean? And then I need some more money. But Paris is funny. I went to somebody to ask him if he could loan money in order that I would have him own part of the film. Well, he gave me a couple of, maybe now he gave me about 1,500 or something. A Frenchman, hardly knew me, except from my past background, you know? Then we left Paris, I never saw him again. And he never chased me because he was so wealthy that even the 1,500 or 1,800 that he gave me for a portion of the film when it's finished, he never asked for it. Or, you know what I mean? It was never a problem. But at the same time, it has a texture that we wouldn't have it in this country. A total stranger walks in there and you walk out with $1,800 you never met before. I mean, how does he, you know, I could have leave Paris and come back to L.A. That would have been it. But that was the texture. That was the texture of that. And still is probably, you know, that's a texture. But because I had this huge reputation because of UPA, that opened all the doors. And then you know, then eventually you meet some people and become your friends and stuff. And so you just carry on.